So this is my prompt. I want the image type to be photographic and the aspect ratio to be 1:1. I click on generate images. Hello people, my name is Ferdy and in this video I will show you how you can get started with creating images with AI within Elementor. Keep in mind it is in beta, so not everything is perfect yet, but I believe this is the future. So let me show you how to get it, what you can do, and how you can benefit from it. So I have my website over here. It only has installed Elementor. I guess you do the same thing. I guess you know how to do that. If you don't, go to the backend of your WordPress website, go to plugins, add new, and search for Elementor. Then click on install and activate it. Now I go to the homepage, edit the page, edit with Elementor. And when you do that for the first time, it will ask you to use the container builder. Right now I don't have it yet, so I will click here. Exit the builder. Now I go to Elementor, settings, features, and I turn them all on, activate them all. And now if I scroll up, I can install the Elementor Developer Edition. So I click on install and activate, activate the plugin. Then I see there's an update. Wow. I click on update now and you see it's in developing stage. Okay, I go to the website, edit with Elementor. Now look at this. There are two places where I can use AI images within Elementor. The first place is in the elements, for instance, the widget element. I can click over here and create images with AI. The second one is here at the container, the style, and the background. Click over here. And over here, I can add images with AI. I go back to the image, click over here. And now I need to connect my website to a free Elementor account. You can do it by clicking on connect. If you don't have an account yet, you can create one for free. I already have one, so I connect it. I need to agree with a few things, approve of a few things. I suggest you read those. Look at this. Now we can create an image from scratch. I can describe an image. So I can say Eiffel Tower and Titanic at sunset. And then you can have different kind of images. Photographic, a background, digital art, handmade, and 3D. You can change the style to landscape, macro, portray, long exposure. So for instance, landscape is horizontal, portray is vertical, macro is really zoomed in like this image. This is macro. And there's portray, something like this or that. A long exposure is something like this, where you see beautiful, how do you say that? Yeah, something like this. So an image that is open for a longer time, technical story, and then it collapses. It gets more light in. I've been a photographer, and then you get cool effects like these. So I want to sell landscape, and again, I have the aspect ratio, square, 16:9. So, okay, I go for Eiffel Tower and Titanic at sunset. Generate images. And there you go. I see the Eiffel Tower. I see sunset. I don't know what this is. Roller coaster that goes on the water. Wow. Wow. I like it. I like it. Use this image. Oh, wow. This seems to be something like the front of Titanic, you know, the moment. Kate Winslet, Leonardo DiCaprio. Check. Come back. So, really nice. Oh, wow. I like it. I like it. What I can do now, I'm like, okay, I like it. I want to expand the image so I can make it square and add some areas over here and here. I can have a generated fill. So I can do something like this. So in this area, something can be added. And then I can say, how's it called? A balloon, hot air balloon. Add a hot air balloon. And again, it's in beta, so sometimes things will get messed up. We'll see what happens. Okay. Now you see it's in beta. So it's adding a balloon, but it's not exactly using the same background. But there's room for improvement and things will get be improved. So that's one of the things you can do. What else? You can also add images on another place here in the elements and in the background. So I go to the style of this container, classic, and there I can have a background. And that's great because then you can have a hero, a big hero, and say something about having a website about walking dogs. And you can have a prompt, and then there will be a beautiful non-copyrighted image over there. I will go back to all the elements, to images, because there's so much more we can do. We can also make use of pre-made prompts. So I click over here again, and here see a few. And I see what the prompt was. Nighttime cityscape of New York with light trail streaks across busy streets, aesthetic, complex color for street level 4K. I can use this image. And there you have it. And then again, I can click over here. It's a square now. I can expand the image. I want it to be 16 by 9. I can zoom out a bit and then these areas will be filled up. I can describe what I want to add. More buildings. Generate. Wow. I can choose 4. Okay, I choose this one. So that's one thing we can do. We can also have this as a container. So I can create a new one. Go to the style. I go to the media library and now I choose this one. You see every adjustment will be saved. So let me remove this container. Over here I can say make it 100% in viewport height. And then I should go to the style. Make it cover the background. And right now the resolution is low, also that will be higher in the future. What else can we do? Well, there's so much more we can do. Okay, I go back to the image, click over here. If I would choose this one, for instance, I can go to the image. Right now this image is photorealistic. So maybe I want to have a variation and then not photorealistic, but I want it to be digital art. I can have a prompt over here. And the interesting thing is over here, should the prompt be more focused on the current image, on the reference image, then I should drag it to the right. Or should it more be based on the prompt so it will have less information from this current image? So it depends on what you want. And again, you can play around with that. Make him look like a cartoon. Because I have digital art, now I can change the style, cartoon. I can change that, but I'm okay with this. Generate images, and then I get 4, which I can choose from. Yeah. I chose this one. So, and again, you can click on it, go for variations, make him smile, generate 4 images. It's a great thing to know that things will get better in the future. So that is what you can do with images. But wait, there is more. Look at this. Oh, and oh man, I heard so many great things that are coming up. Let me tell you one. Don't tell it to others. Or if you do, say that you got it from me. I'm just kidding. You can upload your own image. PlayStation 5. This is copyright protected, so I can actually not use this. But I can click here. I can have a variation. Say, Xbox and PS5 have a baby. Focus more on the prompt. And I want it to be photographic landscape. Generate images. And the image that will be created will have no copyright. The only thing is, it's beta. It's all still in the child's shoes. That's maybe a Dutch saying. This is what I mean. Like, okay, this is what I mean. Like, it's not entirely PlayStation 5. It's also not entirely an Xbox. But that's how you can play around with things. And the future, let me tell you something about the future of AI, where this is going. I can grab my phone. I can make an image of the Kobo reader from a few different angles. And then I can upload them to Elementor or to another tool. And I can say in a prompt, make this look like it's made in the studio with an infinity background, color white. And then I don't have to go make photos of every product I have. Based on the photos I made on my iPhone, based on the prompt, AI will generate perfect looking images for me. But if I sell this in four colors, I can give the prompt saying, hey, make it in four different colors. And then it will be do that exactly. Four colors. Of course, I need to show them which colors, which color codes. So it's a great reference with the original image of the product I want to sell. That's where we're going to. So I have good news for a lot of people and for the studio photographers. Maybe bad news, but I believe in life we can be flexible. And if things change, also if things change for me, if websites can be made with one push of a button and people don't need me anymore, I will find a way to go with the flow. There's always something I can teach people. So that's how I think we should approach life. Wow. Did you expect that when you're gonna watch this tutorial? Like, Ferdy's gonna talk about philosophic stuff and wow. So, what else? There are quite a few prompts for free. If you get out of prompts, you can go to ferdycorp.com/Elementor. Then you can go to products, Elementor AI, get Elementor AI. And then you can use, you get 50,000 credits or 18,000 per year. So you can click on buy now and then it will be added and you have unlimited access until 50,000 prompts. So let's talk about prompts. That's the latest thing. If you want to learn how to create prompts, because before we needed to be designers, we still need to be, but now we need to become great prompters. So if you want to go to prompts.elementor.com, you can find more prompts. Experience the power of AI by editing text. You can copy the prompt. So if I want to get this, I can copy the prompt. Go to image. The only thing is, wait a minute. I paste it. I can even enhance the prompt so it will automatically add more details. I want to be photographic and square. Generate the images. So it's based on this prompt. So let's see how close we'll get to this result. Is Elementor kidding with us? This is not a real person. Okay, this is the first time I'm getting scared by AI. Wow. So what I said, we need to become good prompters because I copied the prompt and that's the first time I really see a really, really good image. So you can definitely check this page out and see interior design. Look at this. Okay, wait. New image. Paste. Photographic. Okay, let's see. So I think you know by now what you can do with it. Play around with it. Wow. Amazing. So play around with it. Later on, I will make a more in-depth tutorial. Of course, I need to play around with it a lot before I'm really can give you good advice on how to use it. I'm impressed. I hope you are too. Good luck with having fun. Let's do one more try to mess it up big time. Image. I go for this lady. And I want to expand the image, make it 16x9. I say add green hair and blue eyes. Then I click here. It's going to make a nice story of it. I click on generate. I think now we're going to have some fun. It's not fun. It's working beautifully. Wow. More hair is added. So I tried to mess up and it did not work. So again, I want to mess up. Variations. Green hair, blue eyes. Enhance it. Okay, image type. Let's make a digital art or, hey, 3D, why not? Style, origami, clay. Generate images. Come on, I want to mess it up. Still interesting result. Not totally messed up. You don't see really weird artificial, maybe this over here. Okay, that's it. Good luck playing around with it. When I understand more about it, I will make an in-depth tutorial about it. And the goal, of course, is to help us to get products without copyright stuff, or images with without copyright, that helps us to tell a beautiful story on our website. And this is only images. Of course, there's more about Elementor AI with text. So let me show you. Heading. I can have a text generated with AI. Slogan for the beautiful city of New York. Generate text. Use the text. And then of course we can bring it to the center. Make the color white. Go to advanced of the heading. Advanced. Oh, sorry. Yeah, I should make the text white. Advanced. Background. Black. Layout. Let's increase. I mean, sorry, still after 24 years, I get confused about margin and padding. So, thank you for watching the tutorial or overview, whatever you want to call this lecture. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming tutorials and have an amazing day. Yes. Bye bye.